car. They are not interested in male car. So my concern is that to make this program more and more successful, we need more manpower in embryo transfer technology. It is true that very few people, if you mention name, only 3-4 people are there who are really trained, though DLEF has taken up this task very extensively. But this now this issue has to be addressed. We have to train more and more people. That is one point. Second point is that about the availability of the superior quality, bone meal superior quality semen. Now the farmer, they are demanding, the earlier the farmer from the Punjab, they were demanding the quality good semen, but the farmer who are having one or two cow or one or two buffalo, they are also asking that. So the database for superior quality is not available. The database is available only to the departments, even the our veterinary officers, they are not available where they can get the good quality semen. Third point is that our animal husbandry commissioner, we have also shared the program on the television. Now, when we go on the DD Kisan, the maximum call we got from where we can get the indigenous cattle, the source of indigenous cattle, that's a big question. Chhattisgarh people, Madhya Pradesh people, Jharkhand people, they are now much interested. So that type of the database, though there is a heart, you showed that website is there. But still people are need that where I can get a good quality Sahiwal or Gir or like that. And the last point is that the bovine breeding act. Only the Punjab has come up or they have agreed. Now the DADF should take initiative that all the principal secretary of animal husbandry, they should be requested to immediately implement the Bovine Breeding Act, and that has to be implemented very extensively. So these are 2-3 points, and last point is about the A2LE which we mentioned. Now every day we are talking about that. Now people say they are against A2 and they are in favor of that. So that type of the literature has to be produced by the Department of Animal Husbandry. And that literature will remove so many things. I welcome your article and I will request, Dr. Shalim sahab, may aapse request hoga, isko aap Hindi mein translate karaiye.
Yes, sir. कल तो कर लेंगे,
परसों
रात का प्रोडक्ट है, इसलिए
लेकिन मैं ये आपसे रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा और इसको आप कंप्लीट कराइए. बहुत अच्छी इंफॉर्मेशन इन्होंने दी है. ऐसे ही जो डॉक्टर यानी का प्रेजेंटेशन, ये हर बार प्रेजेंटेशन देते हैं, अच्छा प्रेजेंटेशन देते हैं, ये भी स्टेट्स को अवेलेबल कराओ आप इसको, और या वेबसाइट पर इसको वेबसाइट पर डालो. थैंक यू वेरी
मच सर. With your permission, since so that things are not repeated, so let me just whatever is happening in the department, just want to appraise you. All of you are experts, but some things are there, the action point is there in many of the things in the department. So let me just answer your questions first. ETT making trained manpower available, it is there on our radar. Shortly, we will have a comprehensive plan in which all of you will be invited for making that, and we'll give you exactly the number of the target wise program. So it will be, right now we have been talking in a very loose manner, but the comprehensive plan, the overall plan, vision document is made. That part is available with us. If you want to access it, is it there on the website? No. Yes or no? The ETT wala. We'll put it on the website. But other saath mein, the actual detailed action plan, we'll make it available. We are trying to rope in all the universities and everything. I know ASC is not very happy with me saying all this, but we have talked many times on this, but let me say it for that. In 2017, when I came to the department, the then secretary and ASC took great interest, and we set up a mass ETT program. Out of 400 embryos roughly, which were utilized. The success result, success ratio varied from 0 to 45%. It showed only one thing. 45% the best was in there's one doctor. You are very rightly saying the one doctor who's doing it in Uttarakhand. 45% was the best. Punjab mein kuch cheezon mein acha tha, fresh embryos mein aur kuch mein zero tha. Pune was zero. As correct and other things. So while overall, as AC says, the percentage of 25% was good, but why should it differ so much from 0 to 45%? Probably there is a lack of training. So we have to go for it. And universities, unfortunately, this is not being taught for quite a long time. So number one, it should be the university should be teaching it. Their own personnel should be used in that, and they should be people who should be able to teach others. That means they should have their own expertise to do it. So that is one thing in which we are trying to do that, number one. Superior quality semen availability, sir, we are making SIRE directive. It is there on the anvil. Hopefully within a month, you will have it. Third, source of indigenous cattle, same thing CMU what Pusha talked of. It will talk of so many things. So one project, along with the SIRE directive, will have the source of superior cattle. We will make it available as to where it is. We also have to control things for natural service, in my opinion. What is happening at this point of time is, like, I went to Northeast after going to Rajasthan. I went to Northeast for a regional review meeting in the south. And Northeast, they are taking Tharparkar bulls for natural service. If you take it, Tharparkar bulls are almost very difficult to get. And if you start doing it for natural service, so we are basically not utilizing to the fullest the potential for that. So that is one thing where we should be more selective, and probably number one thing which we should be doing at this point of time is cut down. Our old policy says in bull distribution 75% for INS and 25% for AI. I think it should be exactly reversed. It should be 25% for NS and 75% for AI. And NS, the lower quality should be there. That is one thing which I propose. And if you agree, we will accept it. A2 is your business, experts' business. I don't understand what you're talking about.
Simple.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Sir, thank you very much for inviting us for this very important event.
Sir, it will be quite useful if you introduce yourself before speaking, because what will happen is all of us will be on the same page.
Yeah. I am Dr. Ashok Pandey from Bio Development Research Foundation, Pune. I would just go to the points which I wanted to make. One thing is very important, which we are talking very often nowadays, and there is a very serious effort going on from Government of India also regarding the consortia for genomic selection. So that is very important aspect which we have to work on, and then try to find out the solutions for our own problem, because you know the reference population and those things are not available in the country. But based upon whatever is available in the Western countries, we can do the imputation and those kinds of things and work out a chip which will be useful for our population. But the major thing in this, sir, is the most important and the most critical requirement is formation. It is already there, but bringing all the players together, including n number of people are already working in this field, but they should be brought together, the data should be shared, and you know the population, then it will be the reference population development can be very easy and very fast also. So that is a very important aspect I would like to flag. Second important aspect is regarding the Breeding Act. Sir, what is happening is, of course, Punjab has already implemented, UP is in the process of doing it, Maharashtra is also in the process. So these are the things which are very important and crucial. But the most important factor in this is, because, you know, sir, Government of India under NDP, the World Bank, has strengthened all the semen stations in the country, many of the semen stations, and they are producing excellent quality semen with a very high genetic merit. But if we are saying that a breeding act of a particular state prevents the use of semen from other semen station in the country, it's going to be very hard, you know, because, you know, we should allow the best semen available in the country to be used in any part of the country, depending upon agroclimatic conditions, the resources availability, the farmers. So that also should be considered and taken the cognizance of by Government of India, and directives or the request should be given to the state governments for that. That is second important thing, sir. Third important is regarding rightly said by Joint Secretary Saab and that A1, A2 Aliyev. Sir, we had about 3-4 months back, we had a national level symposium or workshop on that, and it was agreed. Unfortunately, Vice Chancellor Mohode from Duasu was not there, but then it was decided that there is no scientific proof of this kind of blaming of the milk, you know, A1 Aliyev or something like that. So we should not go unless and until it is proven, either this side or that side, we should not. Otherwise, the milk production in the country which is required to be increased further will not happen. So mainly it is because of the crossbreeding and the indigenous breed improvement and buffalo, of course, no doubt about it. So that is very important aspect, the third aspect I wanted to flag. The fourth small announcement I would like to make, that under support from Government of India, BIOF has already started production of sorted semen. From 28th of September, we have started semen, sorted semen of all our indigenous breeds, crossbred bulls, exotics, and buffalo semen also is available. And there is very good demand from different cooperatives or the state governments and all that. So I'm really happy to make announcement over here that if anybody is interested, we have published a brochure which has been put on our website and which has been circulated. Many of my colleagues were there at the inaugural function. Unfortunately, because of preoccupations and all that from Government of India, there were nobody.
No, but we had other appointments.
I know, sir. That's what I'm saying, because of the preoccupations and all that. But that is what I would just like to flag in this forum. Thank you.
Only one very small point which I wanted to clarify regarding Breeding Act, the problems which are happening by promulgation of acts like Punjab is already in our cognizance. So next time any other government comes to us with their act, Maharashtra has already come to Government of India. So we'll give the comments whenever.
No, this regarding the Bovine Breeding Act, we are emphasizing repeatedly to all the state governments to enact that one, because that requires the respective legislative approval, and about 6-7 states are in pipeline. So we are expecting that in the near future, more and more states will come forward to go on this.
Sir, what he is saying is the difference.
What he is saying is
what has happened in Punjab. Punjab has passed an act, the first act, which says that only semen stations registered in the state will be using only that semen. So lower quality of semen will be available for people in Punjab. That issue is there. I don't think it is going to be sorted out immediately, but probably the farmers of Punjab will take care of that. So this thing is there, but in other states we are taking care. And as sir has rightly said about the raw boy in breeding act here.
Thank you,
Dr. Sham.
Sir, good morning. This is Dr. Sham Zawar. I am the Chief Executive Officer of JK Trust. JK Trust, I think all of you knew, probably is one of the largest NGO in the field of animal husbandry. And we have been operating about 3,000 integrated livestock AI centers in our own 12 states in the country. I don't want to go into the details of that, but I would definitely say about the contribution made by Raymond and JK Trust in the field of embryo transfer technology. It was well back in 1975, almost about 40 years back, when I started with embryo transfer in sheep, which was the first time introduced in the country. And we did a lot of work on embryo transfer in sheep on a large scale. Subsequently, from 1980 onwards, we did a lot of work on embryo transfer in cattle, particularly in vivo embryo transfer. And we supplied a lot of bulls born out of ET throughout the country. And then there was a gap for almost about 10 to 15 years. But of late, since 2016, JK Trust launched this project of the Assisted Reproductive Technologies, Advanced Assisted Reproductive Technology Institutes at two places. One is near Pune, and it's about 70 kilometers, and another is in Chhattisgarh in Bilaspur. And these two labs, ETIVF lab, they are, really very well developed lab. And we were, for the last 2 years, we have been working extensively on IVF program. And we are exclusively focused right from beginning, from September 2016, we have been focusing in line with the Rashtriya Gokul Mission. We have been focusing on the indigenous breed and their performances. So we brought some Saival, Tharparkar, Rathi, Gir, and Ongol. These animals, we brought it to our project over there. And we started working on them. And I, let me tell you something very important. See, Bos Indicus breeds, there is a tremendous advantage at our disposal that they don't need a stimulation. We are doing all our OPU work, and we did about 2000 aspirations up till now, the OPU techniques. And they don't need any stimulation. You just take a cow and you just start aspirating it. Most important thing, let me tell you, that you can aspirate a cow twice in a week. If you get, if you do it twice in a week, you get a better results even doing that once in a week. This is Brazilians have found out, because they have a lot of Bos Indicus breeds with them. And we have been working on gear very extensively. Now looking at the demand which we have got, we opened a special satellite lab into Rajkot, sir. And there are so many programs.